It's Metal Monthly time. It's Metal Monthly time. It's new metal time. It's no new metal time. Howdy, Banger fans. Blaine Smith welcoming you to another Metal Monthly, Banger's monthly look at what's coming out in metal albums. Thanks for coming out. I appreciate having you here. I love doing this. This is a regular show where I pick five of the best underground metal albums coming out every single month. But first, off the top, we always list some of the bigger and noteworthy releases coming out for you to keep an eye out for. So let's get cracking with August. Up first is today, August 5th. We've got some new releases. Amon Amarth is releasing The Great Heathen Army on Metal Blade. Hey, how'd you get in here? Anyways, Insane Clown Posse is releasing the Pug Ugly EP. It's a self-release. We need a better bouncer. Anyways, Savage Master is releasing Those Who Hunt at Night on Shadow Kingdom Records. And Soulfly is releasing Totem on Nuclear Blast, featuring banger pal Mike Leon. Salute. August 12th, another massive release in Arch Enemy's Deceivers on Century Media. Boris is back with another Heavy Rocks called Heavy Rocks 2022 on Relapse. August 19th is a really big week. You've got Conan releasing Evidence of Immortality on Napalm. You've got Five Finger Death Punch releasing Afterlife on Better Noise Music. You've got Heilung releasing Drift on Season of Mist. You've got Russian Circles Metal Adjacent releasing Gnosis on Sergeant House Records. You've got Soilwork releasing Overgiven Henton on Nuclear Blast. And you've got Spirit Adrift releasing the 20 Centuries Gone EP on Century Media Records. And to close things out, on August 26th, we've got Hierophant releasing Death Siege on Season of Mist. We've got Machine Head's back. Hey, look at that. With Of Kingdom and Crown on Nuclear Blast / Imperium. Not one label could carry that massive record. And we've got Legends Psy releasing Shiki on Peaceville. Well, that's it for the big releases. Let's get to the top five best of the metal underground, as picked by me. Up first should be no surprise to anyone who knows me. I'm picking Black Braid 1. It's an independent release coming out August 26th as my number one pick of the month. There's been a lot of hype for this record. It certainly lives up to it. Let's have a listen. Bandcamp bio lists this as indigenous black metal from the solitude of the Adirondack wilderness, and that's what you're getting. The cover by Adrian Baxter lets you know that's what you're getting, and we're thrilled. Indigenous black metal is a scene, genre, whatever you want to call it, on the rise, and you know, that's fantastic, because as I've frequently said on the channel before, folk black metal is just European folk black metal, and if I hear any more European folk made by some guy in South Dakota who lists blacksmith as his profession on Facebook, but recently did an ancestry test and found out he is 1% Scandinavian, 79% mayonnaise, and 20% C-minuses in remedial history class, I'm just gonna lose my gosh darn mind. But thankfully, we have this to keep me from doing anything I'll regret or not regret, because what you get here is fantastic, very cold, very classic black metal, but then there's folk elements mixed in, and the folk elements are of an indigenous vibe. There's little interludes, two of them throughout the album, that are acoustic, really great, really unique sounding, and then you mix that with the black metal and you get an absolutely fantastic record, and it's all made by one man, and I want to say his name, but it's Sagagasoa. I don't know, that's I can't pronounce fucking names on the best of days. Cool dude, and you know, he's got a great wife, real couple goals. They're doing awesome art, both of them, so you know, couldn't be happier that this record's amazing. Couldn't be happier to present this record to you. If you love black metal, if you like getting some more diverse influences into the black metal, please support, put some money behind this. I love this. Ah! So because I did something completely predictable off the top, let's do something completely out of my wheelhouse and suggest you a progressive record. What? It's Dreadnought, The Endless on Profound Lore Records, coming out August 26th. Yes, this is some progressive metal out of Colorado. I'm loving the portal artwork by Reza Afshar. And yeah, there's no trick here. This is progressive. At points on this record, there are two ladies cleanly singing at each other. That's progressive, baby. So how the hell can I stomach it? Well, first off, there are some harsh parts. There are some harsh vocals. There are some more aggressive parts. There may be a little bit of a Blackened influence, if you want. The other thing is, the progressive sounds really natural throughout the whole thing, which is a strange thing that most people that get really good at instruments forget how instruments are supposed to sound, and they all sound like beep boops. Especially in the drums, you can really hear the music being played by human beings as opposed to robots getting together and trying to challenge themselves in an AI chess match. I don't normally like progressive, and it's a very rude thing to say when you're positively talking about a progressive record, but progressive sucks, and this does not, so that's as best a stamp of approval as I can do, so hey, sorry, and you're welcome. Yes! Back to our regular scheduled program, it's Pelori with, oh god, Quand bien même l'enfer et le déluge s'abattront sur nous on Total Dissonance Worship, also coming out August 26th. A lot of these are coming out August 26th. Have a listen. Here we have some French chaos, I guess. There's a lot going on here, as you heard. Over on our Twitch channel, twitch.tv/bangertv, where Lockhorns is back, baby, we did a Lockhorns on Crustpunk, because Crust has been coming up a lot. It is the most metallic of the punk genres, and it seems to be trending right now or something, because it's cropping up a lot, or maybe I'm just in a Crust mood, and that's why I'm talking about Crust so much. Regardless, there is Crust in here, and I like it. there's a lot of else in here as well. It's black and death metal in the, not quite war, but there is a war vibe to it. There's some grindcore. There's really a kind of as diverse selection of genres to pick from as there are song lengths, from like a minute and 23 seconds to like over 6 minutes. And it's just all done really well, that cool French aggression where they're mad and they want to get out a guillotine in the streets and cut off rich people's heads. That's the energy you're getting here, and I'm really here for that. It's really nice to just have chaotic music that's kind of really stretching those genre limits, not really sure where it's falling. You know, it feels fun, it feels fresh, and look at that album cover. Look at that album cover. Look at that album cover. You can get it on a t-shirt, which I'd highly suggest you do. I'm doing it. Oh my god, this would have snuck in on that cover alone, but ooh, always nice when the music lives up to the cover. Our next record is reminding you that Shredders of Metal is back, baby. We're doing Shredders of Metal live on Twitch, and we're taking entries for contestants now. We're taking entries from all over the world, so no matter where you are, as long as you can make this happen, please do. Click the link below, sign up, get involved. We'd love to have you. Hey, it's been a while since we talked about Transcending Obscurity Records, so let's talk about Morbid Evil's Supernaturals coming out on Transcending Obscurity Records August 19th. Watch the video and maybe buy a pair of shorts with the logo and album artwork on it. Who knows? I said die. So Finland is sneaking in again with some death doom, but this one has sludge up there. Hey, what's going on there? Hey, let's talk about that. But first, let's just do a quick salute to the artwork by Dawid Fijalak. Maybe. The artwork is done by him. How you pronounce his name, who knows? I really like it. Again, fitting that portal kind of vibe from earlier. I want to go into that portal, see where it takes me, and maybe it'll take me to ordering this on a pair of shorts like I was talking about. So yeah, this is Death Doom, but there's sludge in there. And what does that result in? Well, it results in frequently the Doom being incredibly slow, incredibly pulling, incredibly dripping, just like weighing you down, which is a cool effect. But then sometimes with a death metal, they balance that out by really ramping things up in terms of speed and aggression. So you're getting the normal kind of confines of death doom. They're sort of pushing the limits of the edge of both of them, giving you a lot broader of a range, which is sweet and cool, and I like it. And death doom is always fun when people toss in a little something a little different. And I don't hear a lot of sludge influence death doom. Certainly death doom I describe as sludgy, but this is fully, again, in the title, in the genre listings, and I couldn't agree more, and I couldn't recommend this record more. Hey, look at that. Ooh, that's been a weird and wacky mix of taste in our mouth, eh? So we certainly need a palate cleanse for the week, and that's coming in the shape of Acid Blade's Power Dive on Jawbreaker Records, August 12th. Metal from Germany that I am a fan of. When I first heard the first track, I went, oh, okay, this is going to be a fun party record. And then I got the record, and it's a little more epic than I thought it was going to be. It has a little more of a, I don't know, journey vibe, going on a quest, but there is still some of those nice beer drinking kind of party anthems in there. It's a good combination of things. The vocals have that perfect level of kind of jank, slightly jank, but never crossing over into the fact that they're bad, just adding a nice level of character. And speaking of characters, just look at these band, look at what they look like, look at these goofs. You know, music's an emotional thing. I talk about what bands look like, I talk about album art a lot, because it all comes together and gives you a feeling that you can't explain. And you know, when you see some people having fun and they're presenting things in a great way and the music's good, it really enhances the experience. And I hope I get to see Acid Blade live soon, because it seems like it would be a blast. And I hope you had a blast here with me on another Metal Monthly. Hey, look at that, we wrapped it up. Thanks, bye.